We're here with Lincoln Southeast assistant coach Justin Freitag here today in place of Coach Gatula, but a lot of promising young players, coach, in your program as you move forward into 2023. First of all, speak on the year you had. I know it wasn't the season that you guys wanted as a program, but still a lot of bright spots.
We were very competitive. We were in a lot of games. You know, lost by one, lost in overtime, lost with last second field goal. So we were in a lot of games. You know, we started off with Elkhorn South, was a very tough game for us. But we were right in there. You know, ended up losing by, I think, 9 or 10. But that was the last few minutes of the game. We thought we were, you know, into that, you know, all the way through the fourth quarter. We battled through some tough, like I said, losses and then some injuries we had to battle through. We're very proud how we finished and how we competed. I think that was good. Good momentum coming into 2023.
Yeah, you got a number of kids here, six you brought, but seven total on your prospect radar. Let's start with your 2024 guys. Cooper Johnson, a big offensive lineman, 6'5", 290, qualified for state wrestling, two-way guy. What jumps out about Cooper Johnson?
Yeah, he's very very athletic. He can play multiple positions. You know, he played at right tackle, and when Gunner got hurt, he would move to the left, and played some center for us as well, and then he started on defense. He's just a pretty multiple guy. Strong. He just got second place in state wrestling yesterday. Looking for him to be a leader this year on the offensive line and for the team too.
So I ended up having a great year. I ended up playing left tackle, right tackle, and center. So I was able to play any position on the line, started both ways on defense and offense. Just had a great overall year.
What are you primarily a left tackle, right tackle? I mean, what's your role and where do you project at the college level?
So last year I ended up, my main position was right tackle. We had a left tackle named Gunner Gatula, who's currently at Nebraska. And we had a position to fill at center. They thought I was best fit for it. I agreed, and I ended up playing center for a few games until we got that position filled out. And I think at the college level, I ended up will be playing any position.
You can play all five.
Yeah.
And that's probably pretty key to be that versatile, right?
Yes.
How much does that help you, I think?
It's helping a lot. I've got so many coaches telling me that that's like the best chance scenario, that you'll be playing any position online.
Yeah, you've got four or five Division I's kind of talking to you, recruiting you right now. Break down kind of your recruiting process.
So right now I got a UNI offer last week. So just everywhere's kind of jumping out, looking at me. I got Wyoming. I'm going on a visit there in March. Just keeping my books open, going wherever I see fit.
And one of your teammates signed with UNI last year, right?
Yeah, Karsten Bloom. Bloom was a really, really good tight end, D end, and ended up being much of a help for our team.
So getting that first offer, how big of a relief is that to have one on the boat and just kind of see where things go now?
It's awesome. I was super stoked that I ended up getting that last week.
And then Owen Baxter, your quarterback, comes back as a returning starter. He was all city. What kind of guy is Owen Baxter for you?
Yeah, he's a great leader. Pretty calm back there. Leads vocally and just by busting his tail all the time. He's a multiple guy. He's a very efficient passer, all city quarterback, and then he can make people miss when he tucks it and runs it too.
Yeah, it started off, played Elkhorn South our first game. That was a really good game. And then rest of the season, just kind of, I got used to it as I was going through. Yeah, it was a lot different than what I expected, but it was a really fun season.
Yeah, what kind of quarterback are you? I mean, are you a dual threat guy, a pocket guy? I mean, what's your strengths?
I'd say I'm more of a dual threat. I like to see if I can throw first, and if I absolutely need to, then I can definitely run if I have to.
So. As far as the recruiting process goes, kind of break down what you've heard and kind of what's going on there.
So if I've had you and I, they came to school just to talk to me for a little bit. I've been in contact with NDSU and SDSU a little bit. I've been texting back and forth with them. So
what are they telling you? What do they want to see?
You and I, when that coach came, he talked to me about doing stuff in the summer, like 7-on-7. He also said, if I can have a first couple games of the season, if that goes good, then that'll definitely help with my recruiting too. So
Pierre Allen Jr., I mean, you just look at him a year ago. He's grown so much.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing that's going to continue. What do you like about the young Pierre Allen Jr.?
He's just motor, right? He's just in practice every play, confident and just high motor at defensive end. And he's got that same motor in off-season workouts, too. He's a leader in the weight room, getting his buddies out there, getting the team. Yeah, we're looking forward to what he can bring.
This is my first year starting varsity. I made all-city, all-conference, made all-state honorable mention, ended up with 75 tackles, ended the regular season with the most tackles in my class, ended up ranked the number 4 player in class 25, so I think I had a pretty good year.
Yeah, what do you, I mean, what's the next step as far as, like, how do you want to grow heading into now your junior season?
I want to become more of a leader since we got a lot of big guys leaving. I just want to – this is the year for me to, like, pop off and just grow as a player, get more offers, get recruited better, and just have a better season than I did this year.
How many teams – I mean, have you heard from a lot of schools, I mean, after your sophomore year?
Yeah, I've talked to a few coaches, Wyoming, UNI. Went on a visit to Nebraska in November, Oklahoma State, Kansas State. They've been talking to me a lot, so –
What are they telling you? Like, they want you to camp, or like, what's the feedback you're getting?
A few of them came to school to talk to me. They said they love my film. They'll be in touch soon. They can't talk to me quite yet because I'm in the class of 25. But they love for me to come out to camp in the summer, so I'll for sure go.
Now, how tall is your dad? 6'6"?
6'5".
6'5". So, yeah. I mean, do you foresee yourself? You got long arms and legs. Do you think your body's going to keep growing a little bit more each year?
Yeah, I think it will. I think I'll get a little bit taller and add some more weight.
Because you probably grew an inch or two since last year.
Yeah, I was about 6 foot.
How much do you think teams want to see that? Because, I mean, if you, all of a sudden, if you're 6'4", I mean, that changes a lot, I'm guessing.
Yeah, it does.